Hey guys, what's up? It's Erica. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming what's on my iPhone 12. So I got my iPhone 12 right when it came out. I will link the video where I unboxed it. And then about the first month that I had it, honestly, it was horrible. It was not performing well. I had upgraded from the XS and got the 12. I really loved my XS. I didn't really need the upgrade. I had never upgraded like right when a new phone came out. So I was like, you know what? I really want to film an unboxing video. So I got the phone and filmed an unboxing video and everything. And the first month that I had it, it was super glitchy, which I think it was glitchy for a lot of people, but the charge would not hold. I was just having like lots of issues where like contacts were disappearing and like texts were disappearing. I don't know, it was really weird. The biggest thing was the charge. The charge was not holding well at all. And ultimately I took it to the Apple store. When I took it to Apple, they said you just need to clear it, restart it, and just download everything again from iCloud, and it's been working great ever since then. I honestly don't think it's any better than the XS though, to be honest. Maybe the camera's a little bit better, but beyond that, I don't know if I would say it's worth the upgrade, but I do still really enjoy my phone. So I'm just going to record my screen and I will place it here and show you guys everything that's on my phone. I've done these videos in the past and it seems like people really like them, so I figured might as well add it into this month of filming. So my homepage is super basic. I honestly, just a heads up, if you're looking for a really fancy phone or like fancy apps, I don't have those. I'm pretty basic. You know, you got your photos, your camera, your calendar, all the stuff that comes on the iPhone. I literally don't think there's anything that I have put on this page. So very basic. We're gonna go to the next one. So top, we got Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, TikTok. Obviously, I think those are pretty much on every person's phone. And then this utilities, I don't know if I made this. I think it just like came on the phone like this, but I didn't put those, or I don't think I put those in a box like that, but that's fine. Then I have the YouTube app. I really like this app. I feel like since most of you guys probably watch YouTube regularly, you probably have the YouTube app, but it makes watching videos really nice and really easy. Then I have Pinterest. I really haven't been pinning stuff so much lately, but I love Pinterest for like home stuff. I feel like every time I move or I'm decorating a new space, that's when I love Pinterest. But right now I've been in my apartment for the past year, so I haven't really been using Pinterest that much. Then I have Spotify, use that every single day. I drive like an hour and a half total every day for work, so that is needed. I have Tumblr, which honestly, I hate to say, I never thought that I would stop using Tumblr, but it's like been a slow decline of usage since like college. But maybe that's a good thing, because I feel like Tumblr is an app you go on when you're sad. And then I have Poshmark, which if you guys don't know, I sell a lot on Poshmark. I like to go to the Goodwill outlets and find stuff to resell on there. I also just resell my old clothes. Here, I'll just show you guys quickly what my closet looks like. Then we got the YouTube Studio app, which I'll show you guys a quick glance at the analytics and what it looks like. This is my dashboard. I've got like 1,500 subscribers. Thank you guys. And subscribe if you haven't already. Shameless plug. And then yeah, it gives you a nice view of all the activity that's going on your channel. And you can really easily look at your analytics here. This is a really helpful app. I really like it. I do think that it's better on the browser, but it's still great. Then I have Uber Eats just for ordering food, DoorDash as well, Postmates. Got a lot of apps for that. Then Uber for driving, which I have not had to call an Uber in forever, so. Then I have Visco, which I can show you guys. This is just a quick little view of my Visco. I mostly just use it for editing, but this is some of the pictures that I've posted over the years on Visco. And then Gmail, Twitter, Messenger for Facebook. I like to check Facebook Marketplace a lot, so if you check Facebook Marketplace, you kind of need the Messenger app to message people. Venmo, Apple Watch. I have not used my Apple Watch in a hot minute. I really need to. It's just a pain to charge. I hate that it's like a whole extra charger. My Bank of America, Star One, Chase, very basic. Amazon, Google Drive. See, guys, I told you, kind of boring, but Google Docs. Then I have OfferUp, which if you guys have ever used the app Let Go, which was basically like OfferUp, they merged and became OfferUp, but you can see it also says Let Go on it. But you can find like, you can filter if you're looking. I hate it because, like, they took off the free filter, the free category, so you have to look up free, but see everything that's going for free right now. Honestly, I never liked OfferUp that much. I liked Letgo a lot better, so I kind of haven't been using it as much. Then I have Starbucks. That's the app where you can order ahead and pick up. Really useful. Then I have Robinhood. I'll give you guys a little look at it. My past 3 months, I'm up $36, 19%, which I think is pretty good, honestly, but not great at the stock market. I don't know a lot about it, and I don't really know if it's my thing. It kind of scares me, so I don't have a bunch of money in there, but I decided to, like, play with it. But now that the whole GameStop thing, it seems like I should sell everything from Robinhood and trade some other way, because who knows what's gonna happen to Robinhood. So then I have Zillow, which I love to look at houses. Facetune, honestly, I used to use that more. I wish I wouldn't have used it so much, but I did. Then I have a Depop, which I just recently downloaded. Here's just a quick look at my Depop page. I really haven't sold very much. I'm not very, like, I don't understand how to share things on Depop. Then I have Fonto, which is how I edit all of my thumbnails. I'll show you guys a little, like, little tutorial. I downloaded this text. I'll just do, like, hey, YouTube. And I think it's really fun if you have a channel or if you like to make, like, art on your phone or something. I think it's a fun and easy app to use. I got this from Kenna Marie, I think is her username, on YouTube, but she, like, had a whole video on, like, how she makes her thumbnails and everything, and that's how I learned how to do this, and I've used it ever since. It's great. There, see? I think it's cool. You can put, like, pictures behind. Then I have PicStitch, which I think I downloaded also for, like, making YouTube thumbnails, but I really don't use it. And this YouTube thumbnail maker, I think you have to, like, pay for it to work, so I don't really use that. iMovie, that comes on your phone, and I used it, like, once or twice on my old phone. I think I used it to make a little TikTok video on here, because I was having a hard time on TikTok. Yelp. Then I have this app called World Maps, which I was bored one day, and I was like, oh, I want to, like, nerd out and figure out where every country is and learn all the countries, but this game is way too hard. But that's what I did one day. Then I have Google Pay, which I don't actually use, but a few months ago, my sister figured out that, like, if you download Google Pay and you transfer $10 to someone, it was, like, paying you $21 just to use the app for the first time. So we just, like, transferred $10 between the two of us, and then we got $21 extra, so we came out on top. Fetch is actually a cool new app that you can scan receipts and you get points for it. So today you can see I just got 25 points for Target, and then you can get gift cards. I've got an Amazon gift card the other day, but you need 5,000 points, and you kind of get between, like, 5 and 25 points for every receipt that you scan. Okay, this shop, I don't even know what this is. Okay, this is, I think, tracking. Okay, I actually didn't even know what this app was. Tracked. Okay. Oh, this MZ Scope, okay. Gross, but on TikTok, if you guys have seen those, like, earwax camera things where you can put, like, the camera in your ear and it has, like, something to get, like, the earwax out. It's supposed to be better for your ear than Q-tips. That's what that app is. Honestly, I would recommend it to anyone. Some people might think it's gross, but I think so many people watch those things on TikTok. It's like pimple popper now. Apparently cotton swabs are bad for your ears, so even if you don't want to, like, see inside your ear, I think this, like, tool that they give you is better. I have Words with Friends. When I was at home for Christmas break, my parents are super into it, so I was playing with them, but I haven't really played it as much anymore. Then I have My Net Diary, which is basically where you can track what you're eating and your calories. I have used this app, like, on and off for probably, like, 4 years. There's been, like, a few times where I've been good at it and, like, actually tracked, and I think it's a good app. It's, for the most part, free. I don't use any part of the app that's not free. And I still think there's a lot of great features on it, but I really should get back into using it because I think it really helped me. But it's just hard if you're not eating foods that you know how many calories are in, it's hard to track. Fitness is from my Apple Watch. Goodreads, I've just gone into reading, so please comment if you guys have any books you think I should read. But this is where I'm like kind of tracking what I'm reading. Let's see, my books. There we go. I've read 2 books and I'm in the middle of reading 1 book this year, so that's much better than the last year and the year before that. Then I have this app called DazCam, which I downloaded, and you guys can kind of see it's like a little editor. These are just some pictures that I edited. It's supposed to make them like, I don't really know. I haven't really used it or uploaded any photos on Instagram using it, but I think I saw it on TikTok and I was like, might as well try it out, so I have that. Then I have the face app. Obviously, you guys all know, like, makes you look old. Okay, this picture that I had as a thumbnail. We'll do this. And we'll go age, old. Scary because I don't even look that much older. And I also, like, kind of look like my parents. It's really weird. I, like, look like such a mix of my parents right here. But I guess that's what I'll look like when I'm 60 years old. But that's a fun app. And then I have the Uber driver app, which if you haven't seen my videos, I've been posting a lot of David and I being drivers for Uber Eats in San Francisco. Kind of interesting if you're considering doing it as a side hustle and just like seeing how much you can make from it. Then I have the Insomnia app, which is a cookie company that I was obsessed with in college, and they have one in San Francisco. Then I have Waze, which just like gives you traffic updates. It's a helpful app, better than Google Maps. Then you have followers, which just kind of like shows you if you have people that you follow, they don't follow you back, vice versa, all that. Then I have PayPal, which for Depop you need PayPal, I'm pretty sure. And then I have Hive, which I did a video like a week and a half ago about this new social media, but this is my page. Follow me if you want. Then I have the Camera Connect, which is how I get photos from my camera onto my phone. And then I have Amazon Seller, which I saw this TikTok that was all like, all you have to do is go to Marshall's and like scan a barcode and send something to Amazon Shipment Center and you can make a bunch of money. And then I looked more into it and it's really difficult. It's not that easy. So I'll probably never use that. And then SoundCloud, obviously, you can listen to music on there and like, I think anyone can upload to it. So that's everything on my phone. Oh yeah, you guys can see my phone is like the green color, but honestly it's more like a light blue. I think it's really pretty, but I do just have like this OtterBox case because I didn't want it to break, even though of course they say it's not breakable. But yeah, that's everything that's on my phone. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry it's not super interesting. I haven't laid it out very aesthetically, but that's what's on my phone. And make sure to subscribe because I am posting every single day this month. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys tomorrow in my next video.